Welcome back to Raman for Beginners. I'm Dian, and today we'll have a look at the very core of the Raman spectroscopy, the Raman shift.
Last time, I explained the scattering of light and how it depends on wavelength. Now you also must know that the wavelength itself tells you about a photon's energy. A short wavelength means high energy, and longer wavelengths, of course, lower energy. When light scatters, the wavelength of the light, and thus its energy, can be altered by scattering process. With a very small chance, 1 in 100 million scattered photons loses energy to the molecule and change its wavelength. The Indian scientist C.V. Raman observed this effect for the first time, and he won the Nobel Prize in 1930 for this discovery. If a photon is scattered without losing energy, we call the process Rayleigh scattering or elastic scattering. If a photon loses to the molecule, we call the process Raman scattering or inelastic scattering. If inelastic scattering happens, the scattered photon carries a different amount of energy. This difference is called Raman shift, and it's like a fingerprint of the matter. In the next video, we will go deeper and see why inelastic scattering happens.